So let's start by visiting a bistro. Imagine the following situation. I go to a bistro, sit down, open the menu, and what do I find there? I realize that they serve filetto alla rossini. It is my favorite dish. It is made of, just listen, it is made of filet mignon, fried in butter, topped with a big slice of foie gras, garnished with truffles, and finished with Madeira wine. Ah, and served on a crouton, I think also fried in butter. In short, it has everything you need to help your cardiologist to make a fine living. You know, it really helps that one. Now it is really tasty, but the problem with that dish is that it is also very expensive. Okay, let us assume that it cost £100. Okay, now I must decide to order or not to order, okay? It sounds very Shakespearean, but to tell the truth, the decision, it is really simple. All I have to do is to decide whether the pleasure this dish will give me is worth the price of £100. Of course, we must remember that £100 means different things to different people. You know, to a street beggar, £100 is a fortune. But if you were to deposit £100 into the bank account of Bill Gates, or maybe even better, the Rothschild family, not even the Scotland Yard detectives will be able to find it, you know, since it vanishes, okay? You don't know where it is. But it is a really simple decision and has nothing to do with game theory. So the question is, why am I telling you all that? Oh, the answer is, how does game theory fit here? The answer is that now we'll assume a little bit different situation. Now I go to the same bistro, but not alone. I'm going now with 9 of my friends, making a total of 10 around the table, okay? And we decided not to go Dutch, but to split the bill evenly, okay? This is a much more interesting situation, and strategic thinking is immediately involved here, okay? Usually, I wait politely and see what happens. Okay, for example, I'm just checking what my friends are ordering. Cappuccino, this is my daughter, Tal, okay? She's ordering a cappuccino. And then, cappuccio, macchiato, macchiatone, panone, just coffee, nothing for me, thanks, plain water. In short, the orders are really modest. I listen to all the modest orders, and I am struck by an ingenious idea. I tell myself, now I want filetto alla rossini, you see? Why to pay £100, yes, when I can make other people happy by seeing me, you know, enjoying it? So I will treat myself to a Rossini gourmet opera. This decision sounds to me economically and strategically sound, since it will cost me something like £10 and a little bit more. Wonderful. But is it really a wonderful idea? What do you think will happen? I think in 2 seconds, maybe 5 seconds, what will happen? The orders will be changed, okay? Apparently, my move was a declaration of war, okay? It is not a small matter, okay? The waiter is called back, okay? Called back. And everyone suddenly remembers that they are really hungry, yes? Really hungry, and they are especially hungry for the high end of the menu, okay? Instead of panone, a Robichon truffle pie, okay? Instead of cappuccino, caviar beluga, accompanied by pink champagne, and so on, you get the drift, of course. All my friends suddenly appear to be feinschmeckers, okay? It is an economic disaster. When the check finally comes and the bill is equally split, each diner has to pay £200, okay? I realize that I made a mistake, okay? By the way, one of the things game theory teaches people is, I think it is a revolutionary one, it is to think before making decisions. You know, it is a... I know it is really hard. I try in Israel, I think 5 times a week, to tell people, think before making a decision. They are telling me for hundreds of years we are doing things, and then checking what is happening, okay? It is not a good idea, okay? So it is better to think. Now, I understand that I made the mistake, but the really interesting question is, am I the only one, okay? Things, my friends fighting for their pride and not attempting to avoid, you know, to being fooled. People don't like to be fooled. They paid a lot of money for food they never intended to order, okay? So if they made a mistake or no, you will decide. But I can tell you for sure that it was the last time we went out together, okay? Paraphrasing T.S. Eliot, he said, friendship once ended cannot be mended. Okay, it was the last time. This is the way the cookie crumbles. But this incident in the restaurants is a true example of game theory. Okay, I can now pin down game theory to the shortest version. Here it is. Game theory is the mathematical formalization of interactive decision making, okay? Since we are not going to do mathematics, you know, people don't like mathematics. Life is hard enough without mathematics, okay? So mathematics. So I can even try a version which is shorter than the shortest one. It is a kind of paradox. And here is the shortest version indeed. Game theory, it is just interactive decision making, okay? How to make decisions when you are not alone. And when you are not alone, we should assume in most cases that other players are as smart and as egotistic as we are, okay? But we should not assume that we know what their deciding factor is, because people are very, very different, you know? And when you make a decision, you have to consider emotions, not only mathematics. This is one of the reasons that the last years I deal a lot with the psychology of game theory. Though I'm a mathematician, my main PhD is in mathematics, but I deal a lot with psychology since envy, schadenfreude, hatred, desire for fairness, egotism, refusal to be fooled. This is really important issues, and you must take them into consideration. And recent researches show that people not only don't know what makes other people tick, but quite often people are wrong about what makes them tick. You know, we not always know what will matter for us and what not. In any event, don't expect to order Filetto alla Rossini, okay? While all the others are drinking coffee and soda and wishing you bon appetit, Haim Shapira. Yes, we are so happy that you are happy. Maybe you want also a foot massage while you are so enjoying your Filetto alla Rossini. You see, it will not happen, okay? So now we know what game theory is all about.